may have seen a video recently where it showed you some of the hacks you can perform on an environmental control system in a US hotel room. This is one of the options that's available in the UK in the Premier Inn Hotel. The other option is a Honeywell consumer unit, which has been basically cut back on the options. You can't reprogram it. Not sure who the manufacturer is on this one, but this one can be reprogrammed. These are the steps where you can basically reprogram it. As you can see, it's got 7 digits across the top. That means it's a 7-day programmer. So the first thing you need to do is that basically there's a cover which comes off, it pivots off. So the first thing you need to do is grab it from here, as you can hear from the click. That's now come away from the main unit. Sometimes find that the other corner is a bit more difficult. As you can see, it just becomes a little bit more tougher. So sometimes what I use is just a sharp point. Luckily I've got a set of screwdrivers, and if you just pivot inside here, you can see that the cover comes away. If I open that up, there's the main programming unit. Serviced by 2 AA batteries. Sometimes you'll see a flashing battery icon on the main unit. That means that the batteries are going flat, so make sure that you tell reception that there's an issue with your thermostat if that happens. So the first thing to do is make sure that the correct time and date actually programmed in here. That's done by pressing the date and time button. And as you can see, it's day 13 in my memory. I need to check whether or not that's correct. So current date and time, it's 23:37. Move that away whilst I put in my PIN code. And as you can see, it is the 13th and the 13th of January. So that's correct. So the time again is 23:37, because we will need that for the moment. So day is 13. Okay. And the next thing we need to do is click on the OK button, which is this green one. Let me click on OK. Now it's asking us for the month. Yes, it is January, so the first of the month of the year. We click on OK, and the year is 14, so we click on OK. So that's basically setting the date. We now need to check the time. As you may recall, it's 23:37. Slightly wrong. It's been a minute since I've checked, so let's put it on 23:38. And then click the OK button. Okay, so the next process is pretty simple. They've got a multi-stage daily program. As you can see, the first stage is at 6 a.m. And then if we click on the right arrow, it takes us to the next stage. Next stage is 8 a.m. Next stage is 11. Next stage is 11 again. And the next stage is 4 p.m. And the next stage is 12 p.m. So what I'd like to do, if you click the program button again, it steps you backwards. 6 o'clock. I would actually like it to be a bit warmer than that, seeing I'm going to be getting up in an hour. So click the OK button to edit the temperature. Increase the temperature. I don't know. These rooms are single heater in these rooms, so 23 degrees doesn't seem that low for that sort of unit, so I normally put it on 23 degrees. 23 at 6 o'clock, that would be nice and warm for the morning when I have my shower. Click OK, that sets 6 o'clock, it then goes on to the 8 a.m. stage. And this 16 degrees is fine, I'll be out of the room by this time. So click OK. Number of times, 11 o'clock, it's 14 degrees, I'm fine with that. Let's keep clicking OK. And then they've used another stage for 11 o'clock. Click OK three times again. Now, 4 o'clock, I'm going to be coming in from work in a couple of hours. So I'm going to edit that. And I'm going to put it up to 23 again. That means that when I come into the room at around 5, 6, half 6, it'll be at 23 degrees, click OK. And then at midnight, I do want it to go down to 18, I'm happy with that. So I click OK three times. So that means at midnight, it will go down to 18 degrees. Now, it's asking me for the next day, so simplest thing to do is just copy what we've just done. Click the copy day button, click OK, and then again click the copy day and OK, click the copy day and OK, and we repeat this throughout the 7 days. Now obviously this won't reset after you left the room, so hopefully the next person likes the temperature that you've set in the room. Probably the only people that need that can edit this are the maintenance people. But now what we can do, once all of those are set, we've set it on auto. And you may have heard a click there, and also the heat icon. The heater now in the room is switched on. You may recall I've asked it to come on to 23 degrees. That will reduce down to 18 degrees when it's midnight. So yeah, hopefully this has helped you. If you felt a bit chilly in the past in the Premier Inn hotel room, and I hope this has been some help. Bye for now.